Just
Thanks so
I
much
want
for
to
having
address,
me.
yeah, I just want to address to my people for just give me 1 minute.
Okay.
नमस्कार दोस्तों, ये मेरे दोस्त हैं इसराइल से जिनका नाम है माइकल। ये इस समय उस क्षेत्र में है जहां पर युद्ध के हालात बने हुए हैं। इन्होंने मुझे बहुत सारी बातें बताई हैं जो मैं इस वीडियो में आपसे शेयर करने वाला हूं। इस वीडियो को देखिएगा और इसराइल में क्या चल रहा है, वहां के यहूदियों के साथ में क्या हो रहा है, वहां की असल हकीकत आपको आज इस वीडियो में पता लगेगी। बने रहिए मेरे साथ। जय हिंद, जय भारत। तो शलोम माइकल, वेलकम टू द वीरेन मिश्रा शो। आई नो द सिचुएशन इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू गाइज राइट नाउ एंड बट द स्पिरिट ऑफ इसराइल इट्स वेरी हाई एंड इसराइल इज गिविंग अ वेरी टफ फाइट टू द टेररिस्ट ऑफ हमास। माइकल, आई नो सिचुएशन इन तेल अवीव और यू आर समवेयर एल्स? आर यू इन द बॉम्ब शेल्टर राइट नाउ एट योर होम?
You happen to catch me between bomb shelters. I'm in my house.
Okay.
In north, sort of northeastern central Tel Aviv.
Okay.
I actually live very close to the central command of the Israeli Defense Forces, which is probably the most targeted location in the Middle East,
I
meaning there
understand.
are
I
many
understand.
missiles aimed at that particular location. I live maybe 5 minutes walk from there. So it's also the most targeted, but also one of the most heavily protected. So we get, when they aim for Tel Aviv, they're
Okay.
basically aiming for my house.
That's fine. That's fine. I can understand it's very difficult because I remember today afternoon, maybe by the evening, I contacted you and you are just running between the shelters and your house. I've been seeing. I know situation is very difficult for you and an entire world is watching how Israel is fighting and the atrocities of Hamas. That's very, very, very. I don't have any words to explain, man. Even in this difficult situation, the Israeli government is giving a very tough fight in all of the fronts. I've been getting all of the updates from there. And I must admit that your Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, he's really a brave person and he's handling the situation very bravely. Are you guys getting enough support from the Israeli government?
The Israeli government, as you may or may not know, has been battling a tremendous rift from within. The Israeli people, the
Okay.
people of this country, have been battling a tremendous societal rift for the past year and a half at least. And a lot of it has to do with the people that are currently in charge. That rift caused a tremendous divide throughout the country that Hamas has also mentioned post the massacre that they carried out, that they used the knowledge of that societal rift to their advantage, and that they used the fact that the country seemed weak to their as one of the advantages to their benefit. The Israeli people have gathered together, have rallied with tremendous morale and tremendous spirit. I will say it is sad and unfortunate that it needed to, that such a tragedy is what needed to happen to remember, or I should say, to remind all of us that we're all brothers and sisters.
Exactly.
But regardless, that is what happened, and we are very united and very strong and very committed to our cause and have put all of the political issues aside. There are all kinds of issues that need to be addressed, political issues as well as military issues. How something like this could have happened in the first place is also going to be a subject of tremendous investigation for many, many, many years to come. As you know, this is the worst tragedy in the history of the state of Israel. And also, there are more Jews died in the past 2 or 3 days. Excuse me,
Yes,
more
I've
Jews
been getting
died.
a lot of updates. I know just today I got the information some hours ago the Hamas terrorists have carried out a massacre in the southern part of Israel, I think, and that's very horrible. I also got the information that they have also dissected the stomach of a pregnant lady and take the fetus out of the stomach. That's really a
Correct.
very, very inhuman act.
Right. That news report just came out in the Israeli press maybe 2 hours ago since we spoke, since I was in the bomb shelter. Hamas monster killed a pregnant woman in her early 30s and then disemboweled her and pulled the living fetus out of her body and let her and the fetus just bleed out on the floor.
Even, you know, I told this information to my mother, and she was so much horrified listening just to this news. It is so saddening. You know,
there are countless accounts of, you know, and again, I don't know how much time we have, and I don't really want to harp on this, but the world really needs, you know, it needs to know the they infiltrated in about 15 different points along the border. And one of the points where they infiltrated was at the Nova Music Festival.
Yeah.
So you need to understand that this is a music festival with 3,000 people, a lot of whom had been dancing throughout the earlier hours of the morning. You know, at a festival, they take all kinds of mind-altering drugs, you know, mushrooms, ecstasy, MD, marijuana, alcohol, whatever. You kids having fun.
Okay.
I imagine some of them probably thought that the sirens was just part of the set from the DJ.
Yeah.
Anyway, they encircled these 3,000 party goers and cut off all of the arteries of escape and just started mowing them down. There are reports of women being raped.
Yes.
That's on the floor next to the dead bodies of their friends. There are audio recordings of Hamas soldiers telling their friends to kill the fat and ugly ones and take the pretty ones back to Gaza with us. There are another report has just come in. They went into Kibbutz Be'eri, which is one of the kibbutzim, which was infiltrated, and they found 40 babies whose heads had been decapitated. Who does this? This is not an act of war. It's an act of war. The Israeli Defense Force, and this is very important, is a defense force. They are not an offensive army. None of their military operations have been on the offensive, unless it was a preemptively take care of, you know, for example, bombing the nuclear reactors in Iran in 1984. So, you know, saving the world from Iran having nuclear power. You know, preemptive strikes, but they don't, as the BDS movement would like you to believe, they do not kill babies, they don't stomp on babies' heads, they don't rape women. It is a organized army in the only free democracy in the Middle East.
Yes,
where
exactly.
All men and women, Indian people like yourself,
yeah,
whether you're straight, whether you're gay, whether you're blue, black, brown, yellow, pink, whether you're a woman, whether you believe in God, whether you believe in Jesus, whether you believe in Muhammad, whether you believe in 15,000 gods, whether you believe in a squirrel, it doesn't matter. You are allowed to live freely in this country. Any of those things that I mentioned just now,
yep,
would get you slaughtered in Gaza immediately.
Exactly, exactly.
All the people that defend,
Michael, what I believe for the world, I might be a Hindu, you might be a Jew, or someone might be a Christian, but for this terrorist of Hamas, there are only two people, one who is a believer, another one who is a non-believer. This is a war of civilizations, if I'm not wrong. And those guys are really monsters. I mean, the news which is coming from Israel, that's very horrible. You know, it's very, very horrible. Don't have any
words. It's very horrible.
And also, Michael, I wanted to ask.
As I'm speaking to you, in the background, all of these like pop-ups from the news are popping up about President Biden, who just finished speaking or is speaking while you and I are having
You've got a good support from USA, though you guys are very capable of just banging out this terrorist but still you've got a good support from US, and I'm very happy with that, man.
Yes, the United States, I mean, without the unwavering support of the United States, this country, you know, would not be here. But I think the most important, the message, you know, people try and they're trying to, you know, sort of draw ties. They say that Israel is an apartheid state, which is, you know, not true. I mean, we have separate roads, you know, ones that go north and ones that go south. That's the only separate. We have Arab members of parliament. We have Arab members of state. We have Arab mayors of cities. We have Arab doctors, Arab professors, Arab teachers. It is a free country.
Yep.
And it is not, it's the fact that they have managed to successfully lie to the world is just unbelievable. And I hope that today and the occurrences that have happened in the past couple of days will show the world who Hamas really are. And I will say, you know, even though we're the ones being bombed in Tel Aviv, you know, we don't live in the south. The people down there experienced things that are just, I mean, it's worse than ISIS, if that's even possible. And it's just horrendous. And the Palestinian people as well, if I may add, just real quickly, they also were taken hostage by Hamas.
Oh.
I believe that there are people in Gaza that, you know, just want their kids to go to school and want to live a quiet, peaceful life. Yeah. But in 2007, when Hamas took Gaza hostage, they instilled a regime of teaching hate and death and violence. And that is what has happened. And it's horribly unfortunate.
That's true, man. Usually, you know, Michael, I've seen when the Ukraine and Russia war started, many Ukrainians started to flee from Ukraine. They just left their cities. Usually we see in war times, many innocent civilians, they just evacuate the city and try to flee to some secure places. I want to know what is keeping you hopeful and motivated to continue living in Tel Aviv right now.
Well, again, I do not live in the southern region of Israel. So it is, although it's, you know, I'm from Detroit. So when I say we are far away from the action, you know, I'm only a 40-minute drive from Gaza.
Exactly.
It's a very small country. It's the size of New Jersey.
Mm-hmm.
But even though I'm only 40 minutes away, it's a far 40 minutes. And like I said, I'm in a very sort of well-protected, well-defended area. And I don't think that we've reached that point where we need to start
evacuating.
Thinking about evacuation. We did get, you know,
I don't think the situation will arise at any point right now.
We are hoping that Iran, who controls Lebanon, has gotten the message from the United States to stand down if they had any thoughts of getting involved. I think the United States is sending over the two biggest warships on the planet to the Eastern Mediterranean. Both of these ships could take out half a continent, shows tremendous support for the United States to Israel. And I mean, there have been a couple rockets fired in from northern border. I know it's weird to say, which is, you know, it's not really a big deal, because in America, if Mexico or Canada fired a rocket over the border, they would evacuate people in New York. But for us, it's not a major thing, although they have evacuated people from the northern region as well. But just so long as Lebanon stays out of it, things won't escalate. You need to understand that in Lebanon, they're shooting different bombs. They're shooting different missiles. The missiles they shoot from Gaza are small Katyusha rockets and the missiles they shoot from Lebanon are ballistic missiles that clear the atmosphere.
Yeah, that's true. That's true, man. You know, today when I got the news of the massacre of thousands of, you know, hundreds of Israeli people, and I saw the photos of their dead bodies, I was, you know, petrified. Many images are circulated on the social media as well. I think this is indeed a very horrible crime. I don't have any words to describe. Do you think that media worldwide is reporting your side of story correctly?
I don't think so. We are used to being beaten up in the press. Like I said before, it is incredibly, I'm not able to wrap my brain around how the
I can understand
fake,
that. I can understand.
Fake, sort of the
there
fake
are many
narrative.
Fake news regarding Israel revolving around the social media.
People just, you know, I mean, I invite any of your viewers or anybody hearing or watching this who thinks these things of Israel to, I invite you all to come and visit this country, and you will see that.
One day we will visit. So we will visit for the show.
We, come on over, man. We, you know, Israeli hospitals treat Palestinian children, Palestinian women, Palestinian men. We provided the entire infrastructure for Gaza. And all of the things that are happening now to Gaza was brought upon Gaza by Hamas.
True.
When you think about, like, they have absolutely not, what did they gain from this operation? There was no land gained. There was no sort of ground covered. There was no, the only thing they did was kill a tremendous amount of innocent people and then bring the imminent death of a lot of other people who are just kept under their regime. The only reason Israel, by the way, you know, Israel, like you said, Israel doesn't need the United States' help to take out Gaza. We could do that any day of the week, twice on Sunday, with a push of a button. We never do that. We are not an aggressive army. We don't just carpet bomb cities. And now they're just saying the numbers are up, maybe 200 to 500 possible hostages in Gaza. So, you know, it's one thing if you're wearing an Israeli army uniform. Sad to say this, but you know, when you're wearing an army uniform, you can assume a slight risk that, you know, this is my part of the service that I'm doing to my country is I'm wearing this uniform and I am a walking target, could be. But when you're not wearing a uniform, when you're a peace-loving flower child going to a music festival or an old lady sitting having her Saturday morning coffee or a 10-month-old baby, I mean,
heart-wrenching, man.
Yeah.
Indeed.
While I'm talking to you, it's like, you know, a student of mine that I taught, he's dead. My friend's son was shot in his leg while they were trying to escape. They barely made it out alive. I was just reading about it while I was waiting to get on the call with you. And it's just, I mean, it's a small country. So, you know everybody.
I can understand. That's very, very difficult for you guys as well, you know. I understand.
Plus, you guys Indians lost their lives. Americans lost their lives. There are Indians and Americans being held captive right now by Hamas. It is an international tragedy on a scale that I have never seen before.
That's true, man. You know, even I have been, you know, updating about the current situation, which information I've been getting from you as well as many other people on my social media. And I've been receiving a lot of negative comments also for that. And you know who the people are who are, you know, posting negative comments. And even I've seen you are posting a lot about the current situation. Are you too receiving such negative comments? Or DMs as well?
I haven't gotten any DMs. The only negative comments I received are when I commented on someone else's post.
Oh, okay.
And then I got into sort of a debate where I had to educate someone about the truth. And that's what I did.
That's good. You updated about that truth. But you know what? those guys, even you teach them a lot, they won't understand what's taught because they are just brainwashed. If I'm not wrong, they're just brainwashed. Even in India, we have a lot of such idiots who are brainwashed and they are just blindly supporting what Hamas was doing. And eventually, I must say that one of the province in India, Uttar Pradesh, the chief minister has taught them a very good lesson over there. You might get, I'll send you the article regarding that, Michael. So, Michael, I won't take a lot of time of yours. I would just like to thank you for time, man. God bless you, your family, and Israel in this dark hour,
thank
perhaps
you.
The most fateful history of Israel. We Indians are with you. Our love, our blessings are with you. Israel will win this battle, no doubt in that. Any last thing would you like to say to my audience?
Just want your audience to don't believe the fake news. This country is a free, loving, peaceful nation with open arms and acceptance for all. And anything other than that is just a blatant lie.
That's true, man.
Here's to better days, and they say in Hebrew, Am Yisrael Chai, which means the nation of Israel lives, and I have no doubt that it will live and will continue to survive, and our ruthless enemies, who are also the ruthless enemies of any peace-loving human being, will meet their punishment in due time.
That's true, man. I mean, Israel is well capable to punish them. I'm very confident. And, you know, you guys are really inspiration. I say that again and again. And you guys are really a very strong inspiration for all of us, you know. And this entire war, this is going to change the world order. I'm very sure about that. And Israel will emerge victorious. More power to you, to your family. Just be safe, man. I know this is very difficult for you. I hope you have your dinner first. I'll stay connected with you. We'll surely connect. And once this battle ends and Israel emerges victorious, we'll connect again.
Amen.
One day I'll surely visit your country, and I invite you to visit my country too. We Indians love Israeli people. We'll love Israeli people. You know, we have a lot of respect for you guys. You know, we share a very similar history. You know, you guys have been prosecuted. You guys have been troubled by the Ottomans, by the many invaders, and even we are troubled in our past history by many of the invaders. You know, we share a very common history, we share a very special bond. You know,
there's also an Indian Jewish community. I don't
yes,
know if
yes.
you know, but there
we have one in Mumbai. I know we have one in Mumbai, and I've seen a lot of Jews in Mumbai as well. I've met few of
them. And there are Indian Jews that live in Israel as well.
Yes, I know, you know. Even when your prime minister visited our country, Benjamin Netanyahu, I don't remember the year correctly, but I remember when he visited in our country, our Indian people were very happy to receive him here. You were very happy.
Yeah.
And I wasn't, and I didn't skip even a single second of the live telecast of his visit. I was so amazed to see that man. He's a very brave person. I must admit that.
He is. Different conversation.
I can agree. I agree. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Michael. Shalom.
Shalom.
Bye, Michael. Thank you for connecting, man. Stay safe.
Thanks, man.
Bye-bye.
Be well.